Okay, we're on the very last part of your production budgets. Now, I know some of you don't like manufacturing accounts. If manufacturing accounts don't come up as question one, they could appear in question nine. So you still really need to know them right. So we're going to go through this. Your manufacturing budget. Normally, your manufacturing budget, you talk about your raw materials, then you have your direct factory expenses. I'm just going to go back through them. Remember your direct factory expenses, there's three things that you could possibly have in it for the Leaving Cert. You have your direct wages, you have hire special equipment, and you have those patent royalties. Okay, so in this one, I'm going to keep it a little bit simpler. You're only going to have your direct labour. Then you have your variable overheads and your fixed overheads. Now, the opening stock of raw materials. I just want you to have be careful of this. They give you all this information. They tell you the materials that you had cost 24 and cost 32. But remember, they're bought in five gram bags. So this is the amount of grams that you have. Remember, you must divide by 5 to see how many bags you need at 24 euro. And the same with COM, all right? Or not COM, material you. Your purchases of raw materials, obviously that came from your raw materials purchases budget, and your closing stock. Again, I've circled the 5 euro for you to remember that you're buying them in bags of 5 grams. Now, I've highlighted these figures here. This is what your opening stock costs you. This is what they expect the stock during the year to cost. So these prices will have changed. Okay, and if you look at your question, it's about 4 lines up from the bottom. The current price of 5 grams of material L is 26, and the current price of material U is 32. Your direct labour, that came from your labour budget. Now, you remember from the honours, they don't actually ask you to prepare that budget, but you need it for this. So it's going to be rough work for you. Your variable overheads as well. They don't ask you to prepare that budget, but you need it for this part of it. So it would be in your rough work or your workings. The fixed overheads, that figure is actually given to you. And if I just find it for you now so you can see where it is. The fixed overheads is the very last figure given to you on page 561. Okay, looking at your budgeted trading account, your amount of sales, that comes from the very first budget you did, your sales budget. Your opening stock of finished goods, again, those figures are given to you. I give you the 110, I give you the 124. The cost of manufacture is my answer from my manufacturing. So that figure there transfers up to here. Okay, and your closing stock. Now, I want you to be careful of your closing stock of finished goods. Now, remember to get the closing stock, it was based on the opening stock figure by increasing it by 15%. These two figures, okay, the value of your closing stock has to be given to you. Sometimes it's not. I'm going to show you in a different video how to work it out if it's not, but I won't be doing that for a while. But these two figures here, where did I get them? If you look at your question, and the question is given on page 562, and part D of the question says, prepare the budgeted trading account if the budgeted cost of a unit of King is 128 and 159. So they give them two to you in the question. Sometimes you're going to have to go look for those, but we're not going to worry about that for the moment. So this is really only for the honours. You're going to have to present it in your manufacturing account, and then you're going to have to show it in your budgeted trading account. Okay.